Hello students, welcome to my English class for standard 7. Today we'll be seeing a new poem titled Ethics. Okay, it has been written by Linda Paston. So what does the word ethics mean? So ethics means the principles, the values, the belief systems which you hold in your life. Okay, so this poem is about ethics. So when this is an incident which the poet writes about, which happened in her past, and she is referring to that event in the present day when she is writing. Okay, so in ethics class, so many years ago, our teacher asked this question every fall. If there were a fire in a museum, which would you save? A Rembrandt painting or an old woman who hadn't many years left anyhow? So this is a question which her ethics teacher, so they used to have a subject like how you all have moral science or value education. Like that, they used to have a class called ethics. Okay, there the teacher would ask Linda Paston's class when she was small. She would ask one important question. Okay, so this like this in a classroom when they were young, when the poet was young. If there was a fire in a museum. So you all would have visited a museum, right? And there are also museum for artifacts like things, and also museum for art, for paintings. So there is an important painter or artist called Rembrandt. Okay, his paintings are very beautiful, very lifelike, and they're very costly since they were painted in the 1600s and all. They are rare, and of course they are very, very valuable. So here such important paintings are in a museum. So the teacher is asking the students to imagine many beautiful paintings of Rembrandt, which is very, very rare and beautiful. His paintings are there in a museum, and that museum catches fire. There's also an old woman in the, see, this is one of the paintings of Rembrandt. If there is a fire and there are paintings and there's an old woman. So they say, the teacher will ask, the teacher reminds the students that she is an old woman. That means she has very few years left to live. She has lived her life. She has few years more to live. She might die anytime. So whom will you save? You'll save the old lady or the painting? The teacher is asking the small children this question just to show them the value of life. Will you give more value to life or to a very important painting? That is her question. Okay, so now Linda is also one of the students there sitting in the classroom, restless on hard chairs, caring little for pictures or old age. We'd opt 1 year for life, the next for art, and always half-heartedly. So the teacher would ask the same question every year. Okay, so 1 year that students would say, we'll save the painting. One more year they would say, no, we would save the woman. We'll save the old lady. Always they would opt either this or that, but always it would be half-hearted. Like they don't bother whether it is the old lady or the painting. Okay this, okay that. Just for the heck of it, they would just answer. Okay. Sometimes the woman borrowed my grandmother's face, leaving her usual kitchen to wander some drafty, half-imagined museum. So sometimes when the teacher asked, so if anyone asks you to imagine an old lady or imagine a dog, if you have a dog, you would imagine your pet dog, okay, isn't it? So the same way, sometimes when the poet was asked this question, for the old woman, she would put her grandmother's face, okay, as if her grandmother has left her kitchen and she has gone to the museum to look at the paintings. So she'll imagine, okay, what would happen if my grandmother visited a museum and there was a fire, so that it would be easy for her to make the decisions. Okay? One year, feeling clever, I replied, why not let the woman decide herself? Linda, the teacher would report, eschews the burdens of responsibility. Now, Linda, the poet, became a little clever. So one year, the teacher is asking the same question year after year. So children are also fed up because they had only two choices, either the old woman or the painting. So once Linda said, let the woman herself decide whether she wants to be saved or she wants the Rembrandt painting to be saved. So the teacher, she said, oh, Linda eschews, means she avoids responsibility. Oh, Linda doesn't want to take any responsibility of deciding whom to save. Okay? This fall in a real museum, I stand before a real Rembrandt. Old woman or nearly so myself. So now the poet has grown up. She is also almost an old lady now. She stands in front. She stands in front of a real Rembrandt painting in a museum. She's in a real museum this time. Now she remembers what happened in her childhood days when she was in a classroom. Okay, now then suddenly she remembered, oh, my teacher used to ask us about Rembrandt paintings, and here I am right in front of a real Rembrandt painting. The colors within this frame are darker than autumn, darker even than winter. The browns of earth, though earth's most radiant elements, burn through the canvas. Now she is describing the colors of the painting. It is so dark, like autumn. Autumn is a season. So it's dark like the earth's brown color. It is earth's most radiant elements burn through the canvas. It is as if it is burning. It is so amazing. The colors of that painting are so amazing. Now she is looking at a real painting. I know now that woman and painting and season are almost one and all, beyond saving by children. Now she realizes that be it a woman, be it a painting or season, or almost one and all. So all these, they are beyond the saving by children. That means they are all so much above the ability of a children to save them. That means the woman, the painting and the season, these can't be saved by small children. They are all very precious, and children don't even understand the value of these. They don't understand the value of life. They don't understand the value of painting or season or anything, because they are small children. Okay, so they don't know the true value of anything. So we should not place so much of a responsibility on children because they don't know the true value. That she understood after she grew up. So this is the end of the poem. Hope you all liked it. Please watch it another few times so that you can understand it much better. All right, I'll see you in the next class. Okay, see you. Bye-bye.